Hey y'all, it's TT of course, and I have a little bit of work to do. So I'm going to record a video while I thread some needles. Oh. All right, so this video will be tools that you need to maintain your frontal, as well as, you know what? I cannot do this in thread needles. So, or could I? Okay, so the number one thing you want to know about maintaining your frontal is tie it down when you go to sleep. I mean, with a scarf, not a bonnet. Now, I say this all the time, and people are always like, so why not a bonnet? Like, I thought a bonnet because I don't want my hair in my face. You can use a bonnet on top of your scarf, but for the most part, the scarf is what's going to do all the work. It's so much stuff. Frontals are not for everybody. To me, frontals are for people who sit around and look pretty all day. Or whatever they do, they look pretty. They don't really have an active life, but a lot of people that have very active lifestyles want to wear a frontal because they like the fact that it's versatile and you don't have to do much with it, but you can. With your frontal, you want to tie your edges down with a scarf. I take a bandana and I fold mine in half, like so. And then I just fold it up. And I tie mine like so. And I tie underneath my hair. So this is how I sleep. Now, a lot of people say, I don't want my hair in my face, or I don't want my hair all over the bed. So a suggestion for that would be to put your bonnet over it or put your hair in a ponytail. With me, I don't sleep with anything on this hair. So even when it's styled, I pretty much just move it up and sleep. So you need to tie your frontals down every night, number one. Number two, sweating. If you have adhesive, which I use adhesive now and I wear adhesive. If you have adhesive, sweating is a problem. The more you sweat, the more often you're gonna have to go in for a touch-up. So that is an issue. Another thing you want to keep, everyone asks what I use for my frontals. I use a Curacare wax stick and I put it on whatever flyaways there are, and I may spray it with water. I do have a water bottle, thanks to Capricia. I don't know where she got it, but I love it. It does like a continuous spray. Like, I love that. Okay, so I love my water bottle, and for my baby hairs, I have a, special mix, which of course is my baby hair cream, and that I use on my edges. If I am going to redo my edges, excuse me, I will take a towel, wet it, and kind of like only get the hairs and take whatever's on my edges off, and then dry it and then reapply it. So you want to always clean your edges off before you apply the baby hair cream to it, because if you just keep caking it up, it's gonna look caked up and it's gonna be white and it's not gonna look good. People who do frontals and people who do frontals good, we're basically performing magic tricks on your hair, because clearly there is a line of lace that we disguise with baby hairs. Some frontal lace is more transparent than others, and I have found out the more tension you use when you stretch that frontal on a client or yourself, the more it will lay and be less visible. I don't know, there's so many questions you all probably have, and I try to answer a lot of them, but I want to really answer the questions as a customer, as the person wearing the frontal. What do I need to know? What do I need to have? A lot of customers don't know that you want to have something like a curling iron or a wand when you want to change your part. So you all know in my previous video, my ponytail was up. So I still have a part here. If I wanted to remove that or change my part, I could part here and use your flat iron or your curling iron to flatten wherever you go to part your hair. So just have like a flat iron or curling iron for when you want to part it. Or some people just want to come back to the stylist and pay for them to style it or redo it or whatever. The adhesive is removed with 91% rubbing alcohol. They even have 99% alcohol. If you go to remove your frontal or you want to pay your stylist to remove it, I use rubbing alcohol. And it comes from, mine is from Walgreens. It comes in a spray bottle. So it's easy to apply. Let it sit for a second and it just removes. Don't remove your frontal until it's time. If you prematurely remove your frontal or you don't let it dissolve, let the alcohol work, that's what causes loss of edges. So a lot of people, for instance, I had a client, she was like, oh my God, you use adhesive now. And she's like, glue really breaks my edges off. And I'm like, it's not the glue, it's the way you're removing it. Cause you can't say, oh, my edges is allergic to glue, but the back of my hair ain't. It's really, your edges are fragile. Your edges do a lot every day. This is what gets touched on your hair the most. So of course it's more fragile than the rest of your hair. So honestly, the glue is not what breaks people's hair off. The way you remove it is what tears your hair out. So you want to you don't want to remove your frontal prematurely. And you also want to let the rubbing alcohol work. Let it soak, let it break down that adhesive, and then you can remove it. Everyone asks, what adhesive do you use on your frontals? Everyone asks. And I had someone comment and say, she's using Walker Ultra Hold. You can see it in the video. And I'm like, this is what I'm using in the video. Like, it doesn't say anything. Oh, and that's another thing, comments. People were like, this one girl was like, oh, I only said something about her edges. I think I approved that comment, but I tried to find it to respond to you and I did not. So I want everyone to know, any negative comments on my page gets deleted. From here on out, there in the past, some stuff I would let it fly or I would let somebody else come and defend it. But now anything, like if it's not positive, it's not approved. So if you're under my video saying her edges look thin, delete. Like, I mean, that has nothing positive for this video. That's not helping anybody just reading it. I've heard that a lot of people look at YouTube videos and they go straight to the comments like, ooh, what did people say? These videos, you're not gonna find it because they're not gonna get approved. So the reason why I have to approve every message is because the fools try to come and clown and it's not going down on my video. So yeah, if you got something negative to say, take yourself somewhere else. So, I'll see you tomorrow. Or see you tomorrow, that's what she just said. So, what you saw in the video was this. This is actually what I purchased and I transferred to these bottles. So, this is what I use. I get it in the huge bottle because I need it. I'm going to show you later on how to apply your own frontal. When this gets loose and I have to take it off, I'm going to record that video and show you all how to touch up a frontal because a lot of people ask that. So, if you all have questions that I did not answer, please leave a comment, of course. If you found something funny or crazy or, girl, you should have did this, drop a comment because you all know I read them all because I have to approve them all. So, I read every single comment. I love you all so much. I thank you all so much for the support. I'm trying to become more steady with my video uploads. Every time I think of something, I record a video. So, yes, I hope you all are enjoying the channel. Thank you to everybody who has newly subscribed. I've gotten like 10,000 I've gotten like 10,000 new subscribers in the past 28 days. So that is amazing. Welcome you all to my channel. I hope you all have found all the other videos useful. And I promise the ones I post from here on out will be useful as well. I think that's it. Okay. Well, yeah, I'll see y'all later. Thank you for tuning in and checking out this video. And I will see you later. Yeah. Oh, did y'all turn on, do y'all have the notifications on for when I post a video? Drop a comment below. I want to know if you do, if you like getting notifications, or if you all have it turned off and you're like, no, I really don't like to see it. So let me know, because I have everybody I'm subscribed to, I turn all notifications on, because, and I get it all day. Like, I just be looking like, oh, such and such uploaded a video. Like, I just want to see. So yeah, my videos are always at random times. I try to upload them when people are free, like either early in the morning and you're getting ready to go to work and you can listen to me on your way, or when you're getting off. So right now it's getting off time. So yeah, I will check y'all out later. Y'all will see me later. I'll post the next video soon, I promise. And let me know if this video was helpful to you. What else? That's it. Alright, I'll see y'all later. Of course, y'all know I work from home, so I'm gonna give y'all a little tour since y'all sticking around. So, it's not quite finished yet, but this is my room. There's a lot of things of sentimental value in here, and I will show you all. So, you all know that this is my favorite stuff I use on all my clients. And I use this between their braids after I get done braiding. Of course, my baby hair cream, when people purchase it, they get a little information with it. My favorite hair care wax stick is there. Edge controls that I love. I actually love both of these. And of course, my grease that I use on all of my clients. I got these designed at Vistaprints. So of course y'all saw my YouTube plaque already. And yeah, this is just a quick tour of my room. Yeah, it's just stuff storage. I've had all the time. I have my little Keurig for my clients, my little Tiki Digital cups. I have more. Of course, I have the mini fridge stocked with snacks for the girls. And yeah, that is my friend that passed away. I keep her in my hair room at all times. She's always on my mirror. So yeah, this is my hair room, you guys. And this is my stand, which I work with every day. And of course, my newer light. This is what my phone sits on when I'm recording my YouTube videos. This is where I put all my needles after I thread them, which I'm about to do now. So yeah. All right. I'll see y'all later. And maybe I will post an updated video when my stuff is actually hung up on the walls. Okay.